What website died that you miss the most? Barbie.com. It's just the Mattel site now, but it used to be loads of fun games with terrible sound quality and based on the early movies like Rapunzel and Magic of Pegasus. You could navigate to My Scene, Polly Pocket, and Everything Girl from there too. I had learned some curse words around the time I started playing on these online sites, and I tried to name my Barbie shit, and Barbie said something like, "Oh no, that's not a very nice word, you will have to choose another name." I remember laughing with my sister so hard, we typed in all sorts of dirty words and kept laughing when Barbie would deny us. Anyone else used to browse FML or MLIA? TFLN, text from last night was my favorite. Dude, I used to search by area code to see what the dumbasses in my area were up to. Always good for a laugh. The old Pottermore. The new one isn't asterisk bad, asterisk per se, but the old one was awesome. I miss going through amazing illustrations and trying to find the things hidden within the monsieur. Unfortunately, I was young when I first discovered the website, so I didn't appreciate it as much as I would now. And I only got to use it for a year before they changed it. I took the old sorting hat test, and by the gods, I'm not taking it again. There's no fucking way I'm a Gryffindor, and I will stand by that until I die. Crack. I mean, technically it's still around, but it's fucking dreadful now. Same with Eurogamer. I used to lose an hour a day because of Cracked when it was good. Every well-researched article would have me running all over the internet trying to learn more about whatever subject it was. Now, it just makes me sad. I'm often sad that it's gone. At the same time, there was a period when it was still amazing, but you began to think, seriously, how many topics are left to come? It's probably food. The original writers have gone on to regenerate it like a phoenix from the ashes. Stumble upon, helping you waste your time more efficiently. Quizilla. As a 12-year-old girl, this would be the hotspot for fanfics, quizzes, and polls featuring your favorite fandoms and characters. I was very much into Naruto fanfics at this time, would spend hours on that site. Now it's gone, and I can't even look up my old writing for good nostalgia fun if I wanted to. Truly tragic. I remember it was so fun. Just another IKEA catalog was a painstakingly researched gift catalog of IKEA objects found in porn videos. I think it was originally hosted on Tumblr by a German dude, but got taken down a few years ago. This is the site I never knew I needed in my life. How devastating, I never saw it. Groove Shark. This was the music plug GGGGGG in school. MySpace forever. I discovered so many bands. It was my Spotify before Spotify. Isn't MySpace still up though? The site technically is still up, but it's almost all but dead at this point, unfortunately. Regret C. A legitimately hilarious website dedicated to terrible things sold on Etsy, which later turned out to be run by a voice actress who couldn't handle the stress of it anymore. It was originally intended to be kept up as an archive when she quit. But now nothing exists of it except for a book of assorted items that made it onto there. That website was golden. She coined the phrase whimsical fuckery when explaining some of the shit she came across. Up a lot of Etsy's crazy nonsense. Homestar Runner. Strongbad email teen girl squad trog Doro good times. I miss Strongbad so much it burninate the IMDb message boards. The fact every movie to have ever existed had its own dedicated message board at varying levels of activity, but still, it was amazing. I miss those days. Yep, and I'm still mad at them for their ridiculous reasoning for shutting them down. In my opinion, they simply pulled a Rotten Tomatoes there and shut down in-depth movie criticize monsieur. Reddit has become a close enough replacement for it, I suppose, but it was amazing just how specific those message boards could get. There'd be a board for an obscure movie no one's thought about in ages, but you could make a post anyway, and chances are at some point, Someone else would remember that movie too and come along to comment one day. And it would always be a thrill when someone did. Polly, it was so relaxing and fun making your own outfit, sad face. Came here to say that I'd go there instead of trying to get my Sims game to work. I was thinking Stick Deep, but now I feel they're old. I credit that site for getting me into System of a Down back in 7th grade. Hyperbole and a half. I think about Ali from time to time and miss her silly posts, but also her posts about depression were top notch. Don't scare me like that. I inferred from your post that it was suicide_x to anyone else wandering through here. She's alive and well, just taking time to figure herself out. No, their arrangement with GameStop carrying 5% of their stuff is not equivalent in any way. Wait, Think Geek is gone. When did that happen? A few months back. I think there's a handful of physical retail locations out in the wild. But the dedicated website is completely gone. I think since they were absorbed by GameStop, they're not technically dissolved, so it probably didn't get much attention, like when Toys R Us went under. More of a faded away situation. Geos, there's complete archives of it out there, cause the whole thing can fit on a PS4. https://www.geocitiesarchive.org/aspx. I had a MIDI of Bohemian Rhapsody streaming from my GeoCities page. It was the Club Penguin rewritten is a great site that has kept the game alive. It doesn't have as many players as Club Penguin did originally, but it's still great. However, in a couple of breaches, CPR, Zanga, OMG Pop, I loved playing games with friends in there, like Draw My Thing or Pool. I really miss it. I also miss Yahoo Music and the beginning days of YouTube, the real Kasanime site. All of the remaining ones are virus-ridden trash. Lego Universe. My dad died when I was in 4th grade, and I shut myself in completely. I rarely talked to friends and had trouble when I left the house. But for Christmas that year, my mom bought me the disc. I spent hours playing that game. It made me feel happy and like there was still a little fun. I know it sounds pretty stupid, but I loved it. Being a 4th grader, I didn't really look at the updates or anything. And one day the game just shut down. And I had no clue it was coming. While I was sad about it, it was nothing compared to how I was before playing the game. I honestly still look fondly on it. I was so sad when they discontinued it. I even tried to start a petition in class to try and revive it, lol. Got 2 whole signatures. I would have signed. Stickly Comus, Ask Jeeves. Oh, Ask Jeeves. Literally the first place that 12-year-old me typed in the word pornography. Whilst nervously looking over my shoulder for the next 25 minutes while one blurry image loaded. Line by line. Crack. It was my go-to website before this one. I still go back and read articles from like 2010. Still, Crack led me to the Rubber Bandits, which has been fantastic. Hamster Dance. Comus, it hasn't actually happened yet. But every time I open Google Chrome, I get a notification that Flash Player will no longer be supported after next year. And that makes me sad. Because I grew up on Flash games and Flash animations. It feels like the end of an it. Pixie Hollow, based around Pixie Hollow, kinda like Club Penguin. It was closed, I think, when Disney got Club. I used to play that for hours because you could get pets and stuff like that. Please tell me someone remembers this. Neo, my dude, Neopets is not dead. It's not dead exactly, but it's nothing like what it used to be. I miss the primetime Neopets. Back before they went crazy censoring pretty much everything, and now there are advertisements everywhere. It just doesn't have the same feel anymore. Edit to add that, and when they decided to make everyone log in again and confirm their identity, I couldn't do it because I lost access to that email, etc., so I had to start all over. Still a little salty over that. Lol, not a single website, but just early 2000s internet in general. Websites were so straightforward and to the point. Ads were basically non-existent and a page would load everything the website had in one go. Absolute. I'm so sick of those pretentiously animated not a website looking websites that spring up like mushrooms everywhere. If I open your website, it's because I seek information. I don't feel like clicking myself through a washed-up art student's wet dream, monsieur. I don't care for animated collages about your company's philosophy. And I don't want to have to guess how I get from it to be around here. Gaia Online was just a fun forum that rewarded you by posting and browsing mini clip or addicting games. Those were my childhood websites. Not a website, but cats are in LimeWire. Lincoln underscore park underscore underscore in underscore the underscore end. MP3X filled with .com talk about a depressing day for my 11-year-old self. Dude, you just brought back memories I didn't even know that I had. I distinctly remember loving the videos.